Okay, in today's video, we're going to talk about Meru's policy enforcement framework. Now, as wireless LAN becomes the primary wireless edge, obviously all kinds of different application traffic from multiple services and different user classes flows through the wireless network, and the wireless network needs to treat different packets differently. Likewise, users in different locations need to be given different kind of access. So we have a overall sort of comprehensive policy framework that includes security, firewalling, access control, and quality of service built into one. And if you look at the different aspects, it includes user-based policies, service or SSID-based policies, location-based policies, IP-based policies, and application-based policies. So what I'm going to do right now is explain how these policies are set up and what the different treatments are. So consider a university, and for simplicity, we will consider three buildings. So maybe there's a student commons that is served by one access point. There's a dorm that is served by one access point. And maybe there's an engineering department that's served by one access point. So think of it as commons, dorm, and some department. Now, the university might have two SSIDs. One SSID that's only available from the commons area, and maybe that's a guest access. And the second SSID might be one that is available pervasively throughout the campus, and that is called the student SSID. Right? So a guest can only access the wireless network while they're in the commons area, while a student can access the network anywhere in the entire campus and roam around while still being in the wireless LAN, right? And retain their IP addresses and their properties and things like that, of course. Now, we want a further restriction wherein the student gets different policies in the commons and dorm areas from the department. So for example, in the common and dorm areas, maybe the student is allowed to access all kinds of applications with equal priority. While in the department, maybe access to certain sites or certain subnets are forbidden, and priority might be given to certain types of traffic characteristics, and we'll talk about how. Okay? So this is a particular setup that we want to explain in terms of sort of how we enable the different policy enforcements within the framework of the setup. So in Meru, you can set up something called ESS profile, and I'll explain momentarily what that is. And associated with an ESS profile, you have at least four parameters. The first one is the advertised SSID. The second one is the set of APs over which this ESS profile applies. The third is the VLAN to which all traffic from this ESS profile is mapped. And the last one is something that we call a filter ID that is used for policy enforcement that is applied to any user who connects to this ESS profile. So taking this example, let's say this was AP 1, 2, and 3. Yeah? So taking this example here, we have, notice, three ESS profiles and two advertised SSIDs. So we'll call ESS profile guest with an advertised SSID also of guest. And this applies only in AP1. And let's say it got tagged to VLAN 10, and it got a filter ID of 4. Now we want to create two student profiles. So let's call this S1 and S2. Notice that even though the profiles are different, because we want the policy enforcement to be different on them, the advertised SSID itself is the same. So the advertised SSID is still student. And S1 gets applied to AP1 and AP2, while S2 gets applied to AP3. Now, maybe when the student is in this location, in other words, commons and dorm, maybe they get put on VLAN 11, while when the student is in the department, that traffic gets put on VLAN 12. And likewise, let's just call this, S1 and S2. So notice that these filter IDs are alphanumeric tags. Okay? So let's step back for a moment and see what we've created here. So we've created three profiles based on two advertised SSIDs. And therefore, a student can walk around wherever they want without losing connectivity. But on the back end, depending upon where they are, they will get different filter IDs that are used for policy enforcement. So notice that what we've done here is essentially created these policy enforcement tags that are a function of the SSID and the location. Right? So it's a location plus service-based policy mapping that we've got so far. Now, when a particular device comes into the network, it is possible, based on a radius server or a backend policy engine, to override both the VLAN and the filter ID for a particular user. So a user might get their filter ID or policy tags based on the service and location that they connect to, but this can further be overridden by means of a backend policy engine, and that provides the additional user level construct. So for example, you might have user U1 and U2 both connecting to, the student SSID in the department, but user U1 just gets the standard filter ID S2, while user U2, based on radius specifications, might get a different filter ID S3. So if you step back now, what you can see is, on a per user basis, we have been able to allocate this filter ID tag that is user-based, service-based, or SSID-based, and location-based.